Hello, I am Anna, Quality Assurance Director at Flex Databases. I have more than 10 years' experience in clinical trials, used to work as a GCP auditor, and joined Flex Databases team 6 years ago. Flex Databases is an e-clinical software development company. Flex Databases enables you to take clinical trials to the next level with e-clinical platform, organized data, transparent processes, and compliance with regulations. We do understand that our clients are the regulated companies. We know the regulations and build compliance into our processes and the system we develop. I will tell you about the software validation approach we have at Flex Databases, what we provide, and how we support our clients during the validation process. Here is the plan for the video. What is validation and why it is needed? Validation flow. What documents should a regulated company have after validation? What Flex Databases provides and covers? What is left for a client to cover and how we can help? And I will share with you clients' feedback about Flex Databases validation approach. So we begin. Do we really need the validation? The answer is yes. The validated software is a regulatory requirement. All the applicable regulations say that validation is an essential part of good clinical practices and an important element of quality system. The draft EMA guideline on computerized systems say that we do have to confirm that the system is fit for purpose, that is, we have to validate it. There are two parties who are involved into validation, the software developer and the end user, that is, the regulated company. And the best way is to share the validation activities. EMA guidelines say the sponsor is ultimately responsible for the validation of the computerized systems used in the clinical trial processes. They may rely on qualification documentation provided by the vendor. Let us walk through the validation workflow, the traditional V model, and see who is responsible for what. It all begins with the plan. The software developer and the regulated company develop the plans that provide details regarding the activities to be implemented. We at Flex Databases begin with validation plan preparation at the early stages of the development process. It allows us to make the validation process smooth and take into consideration each detail. Some of the regulated companies would prefer to develop the user requirement specification themselves, whereas it is completely acceptable to have it prepared by the developer. We provide formalized user requirement specification for the Flex Databases system, including 21 CFR Part 11 requirements for e-records and e-signatures. You can review it and approve the URS and base your validation plan on it. Functional specification is prepared by the software developer, as well as the configuration requirement specification, which is reviewed and approved by the end user. Software developer provides the operation qualification OQ package, that is the document evidence of the fact that the computerized system has been tested during development. Installation qualification documents IQ provides the evidence that the system has been properly installed onto the properly prepared environment. Validation summary report VSR summarizes the efforts taken by Flex Databases and states the fact that the system has been validated by the software developer. User acceptance testing, UAT, is one of the most important steps for the regulated company in the computerized system validation. This is performance qualification, PQ, the process when the end user gets the evidence that the system performs in accordance with the specification. We are ready to provide the user acceptance testing scenario, or it can be developed by the end user. Though Flex Databases provides the validation summary report for the developer's efforts, the regulated company has to come up with their own validation report to sum up the activities taken by the end user to ensure that the system is fit for purpose. Well, we have discussed the main steps of a computerized system validation and now have the list of the documents to be included into the validation package. The guidelines and regulations say that if the regulated company chooses to use the vendor's documentation, they should have a thorough knowledge about the vendor's quality system and qualification activities, which could usually be obtained through an assessment or an audit. Here is the list of the documents that Flex Databases is ready to provide to you. As we have discussed, the list includes requirement specification, user, functional, and configuration requirement specifications, operational qualification package, installation qualification package, including the maintenance plan, and validation summary report. What is left for the client to cover is to pass the user acceptance testing, to develop the validation plan and the validation report, and to conduct the vendor assessment. How could we help more? We can provide the user acceptance testing scenario and help you with its passing. We set up a meeting, sit together, and walk you through your IT scenario, answering all your questions and assisting as required. We at Flex Databases completely understand that once our clients have validated the system during the implementation, they are in charge of the system change control and might want to keep further updates to the minimum. As a responsible software provider, we know where the balance is. We are aiming to provide our clients with the most recent versions, including the newest features and bug fixes, accompanied by the essential validation documentation, depending on the type of release and change risk level. In this way, we ensure the risk-based change control so that the validated system remains in a controlled and validated state with new releases. I have already mentioned that the regulated company has to assess the vendor. We at Flex Databases are ready to host your audit, on-site or remote. Our quality management system covers all the processes and allows us to help our clients with vendor assessment and provide the full range of supportive documents, including the quality management system documents, the training files of the employees, including CVs and job descriptions, 21 CFR Part 11 assessment, the detailed description of the backup processes, and the disaster recovery plans. We do provide the evidence of data protection regulations compliance and IT security. And so, what do our clients say about the Flex Databases validation approach? Let me quote that. Your UAT process is the best I have ever seen. And many thanks to you and your team members for the excellent support during the validation phase. Needless to say, they are impressed. Software validation is a crucial part of compliance, and with the right approach and supportive vendor, it is not a problem of any kind, yet another amazing experience.